Immediately we finish the songs, three in number, there will be a short playness from the RCCG Drama Group. We are the ministers of God too, are acting.
Is a sound of victory. Simply put, it is the act or the art of singing, of an achievement, of mastery or success in a struggle or endeavor against all odds or difficulties. This, I tell you, is what happened a long time ago to a people chosen by God. God has spoken to their forefathers and said, but sadly that was not the case. They were not living as the chosen of the Lord as it was said concerning them. For famine had taken them to the land of Egypt, where they were put to slavery. Their lives were made bitter with hard bondage. They were made to serve with rigor. And when they could take it no more, they cried unto their God. Hear my cry, oh my God. Attend unto my prayers. From the ends of the earth will I cry. That is higher than I. That is higher than I. And God, the all-merciful one, the ever-present help in times of trouble, heard their cry and sent them a deliverer. His name was Moses. Moses saw the people. He saw their sufferings. He looked upon them. And then he went before Pharaoh. Moses went and stood boldly before Pharaoh. And he declared the word of God concerning his chosen ones to him.
Much time on their hands. Officer,
yes, sir.
These Hebrews are idle. Cause them to make more bricks without straw and make sure that their output of bricks does not reduce. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Nonsense.
Officer, these Hebrews are messy. If you harden your heart and disobey the Lord, He will not do
the works of Hebrews.
If you walk harder,
indeed,
you will have less time for vivid imaginations.
And true to the word of Moses,
God's throne shall be given to you. And that,
true to the word of Moses, the I am that
Amaton, dear Bubedike, show them that he is not a man that he should love, neither the son of man that he should repent. For he plagued the land of Egypt greatly. 10 plagues hit the land of Egypt in quick succession to show the display of God's power. Yet Pharaoh hardened his heart. His people suffered, but he refused to let Israel go. But in all of this, the Lord covered the Israelites that no harm came to them. The final straw that broke the camel's back was the killing of the firstborns of all in the land of Egypt.
To go forward, I will make them walk on the dry land. The Egyptians will pursue them. I will hand in their hands, and I will be honored upon the Egyptians. Pharaoh, his chariots, and best of men will perish in the sea. Tell the people, go forward.
And true to the word of the Lord, Moses stretched forth his rod over the Red Sea. And the Lord caused a strong wind to blow, and the sea parted and became dry. They went over. And the Egyptians, forgetting that God only makes a way for his own, followed after the Israelites into the Red Sea.
Jesus.
And the sea closed over them for the utter amazement of the people.
To the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider did go into the sea.
Join me, sing unto the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider had he gone into the sea.
Thank you. peace. The Lord will fight for you, and you shall sing a new song of victory from now on forever in the name of Jesus.
I want to thank God for the drama group. You did well. I particularly like the way you did the crossing of the Red Sea. That was beautiful. That was beautiful. Well done. And of course, we thank God for our mamas and papas who sang before everything started. Thank God for those who are old and yet they are still serving the Lord.